Hello, I'm Vincent J. Russo of the Russo Law Group and co-host and creator of Family Comes First on CFN. I am thrilled to present our series on long-term care, which will be in three parts. In this series, we will cover what is long-term care, how do I pay for this care, the important role of the Medicaid program, and how to qualify for services. Today, we will discuss what is long-term care and how do I pay for it. Long-term care, sometimes referred to as chronic care, is a range of services and supports you may need to meet your personal needs. Often, it is assistance with basic personal tasks of everyday living, sometimes called ADLs, activities of daily living, or assistance and supervision due to cognitive limitations. It is important to understand the difference between long-term care, custodial care, and acute care, medical or skilled care, because our healthcare system treats them differently. Acute care is covered by health insurance or Medicare, while long-term care is only covered by Medicaid or long-term care insurance. There are three important questions that should be asked. Do I need long-term care services and to what extent? Who will provide the care and where? And how much does long-term care cost? As to the first question, as we age in our senior years, we may need some help with ADLs. For example, eating, bathing, dressing, going to the bathroom, or getting in and out of a bed or chair. Or if an individual has Alzheimer's or dementia, then they may need someone to make sure that they are safe at home while getting help with meal preparation, taking medications, and housework. A geriatric care manager can be helpful in assessing your long-term care needs and creating a plan for you. Once you determine that you need long-term care services, then you need to decide who will provide those services and where. For most seniors, they want to live as independently as possible at home. Informal caregiving by family members is often the first step. But if this is not an option, then home health care agencies are available to meet your needs. Catholic Charities also provides senior services, and they can be very helpful as well. If the senior is not able to receive these services at home, then there are a number of options. Perhaps the senior can move in with a family member. If not, then there are assisted living residences that can provide supportive living. If a higher level of need is required, then a nursing home may be appropriate. Now we get to one of the significant barriers to receiving this care, which is how do I afford long-term care? First, we need to understand that Medicare and Medicare supplemental insurance will not pay for long-term care. There are only three options available: private pay, long-term care insurance, or Medicaid. Let's consider these options. Private pay. Long-term care services can cost $20,000 or more on an annual basis for care at home. And more comprehensive care can cost over $50,000 per year. Nursing home care can cost over $100,000, and in downstate New York, over $150,000 per year. This is simply not an option for most seniors who would be impoverished in a short period of time, literally losing their lifelong savings. Long-term care insurance, which can be an option for some seniors, but for many seniors, it's either unaffordable or they're uninsurable. So that leaves us with Medicaid. Medicaid is the only government program that will pay for long-term care. The program varies state by state as to the levels of coverage and the financial eligibility rules. In our next part of this series on long-term care, we will discuss the important role of Medicaid for our seniors and people with disabilities. For more information on long-term care, you can download for free our Medicare and Medicaid guide from our law firm website at vjrussolaw.com. I look forward to part two of our series on long-term care. Meanwhile, be well and be safe. This is Vincent J. Russo in the Legal Know.